Shalom. This is Bishop Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. I want to start off by saying thank you to all of our Booster Club members for your many donations and much more, your prayers. We've visited faraway countries and strange lands. We've even spoken to dignitaries and were detained for spreading the glorious gospel in Cuba. The truth is that the descendants of the 12 tribes of Israel were scattered throughout the world. Help us on our journey as we continue to raise up the nation of Israel. 12 tribes worldwide. Join or donate today. Shalom.
Babylon can't stop this campaign. Rampage, cause I know why the heathen rage. Cause the guys be bringing it out.
We bringing
this
it
kingdom,
out.
We bringing it down.
Down.
Lost sheep, we'd have been found.
Found.
Wait until we get a crown.
Crown talk.
Yeah. This that crown talk.
Yeah.
Nehemiah don't want to be like Nino Brown now. Cause this that king talk. Real life king talk. Like Solomon, I see things clearly like a greenhouse. The wordplay can't get colorful. The scriptures cutting you the butter too. Not to mention we a living legend. Don't know what to do when a myth is standing right in front of you. You better watch and just take notes. The Father sent the flood, then a rainbow. But his son coming back with fire. So it ain't gonna be no more scapegoats. Let me tell you what the prophecy. Unparalleled with the prophecies. Stopping frisk, bodies in the street. My people property in this monopoly. Call it America, where the dreams come true. When nightmares and the demons come to the sodomite agenda, I don't give a damn if you offended.
Hey, what the fuck are we? Let's go to First Corinthians.
Teach him, man.
First Corinthians 6.
Bring it out.
Let's get it. Let's go in the Bible. I want you to say, I was telling that man, I asked him a question, he told me this. Everything I'm telling you, I'm going to get it from right here from the Bible. So
that's
when you
right.
Go back and read yours, you'll see it again. Read that.
First Corinthians chapter 3, verse 16.
Uh-huh.
Know ye not that ye are the temple of God.
Don't you know you're the temple of God? If you don't mind, take your head out. You already had it out. Read.
And that the Spirit of God dwelleth in you.
The Spirit of God will dwell into us.
Right.
Dwell
right.
In us. If we repent, it'll dwell. But he cannot dwell in us because sin and unrighteousness cannot dwell together. It can't happen. Read.
If any man defile the temple of God.
If any man, you a man? I'm a man. All these men out here says if any man. So that's talking about all of us. If any man what?
If any man defile the temple of God.
Uh-huh.
Him shall God destroy.
Him shall God destroy.
That's
destruction
right.
To those that defile the temple.
That's right. Right.
You see that? Give me a minute. Now keep going.
For the temple of God is holy.
Read.
Which temple ye are.
Which temple ye are. You are. We are. You see that? Read. Now give me Colossians. I want to get
Colossians.
Huh? Yes, sir.
Read it out. You asked me, you said, even spoken weed, right? Let me get you another scripture. All right, watch this. Watch this. The Bible ain't gonna lie to you either. Watch this.
2:8.
Yeah, 2:8. Read.
Colossians chapter 2, verse 8.
Uh-huh.
Beware lest any man spoil you through philosophy.
Don't let a man spoil you through philosophy. That's what Christianity has done to our people.
That's
why we think, pay attention, sister. That's why we think that it's okay for us to drink, get drunk, break the Sabbath day.
Right.
Because Christianity has no objective to that.
Right.
As long as you come in here on Sunday, and empty out your pockets.
Right.
You can go out there and do whatever you want to do.
Right.
That's right.
That's Christianity.
Bring it up.
Right.
But you're not going to get Christianity out of this Bible.
That's right.
Right? We're going to give you the word of God out of the Bible.
That's right.
Read.
Beware, lest any man spoil you through philosophy.
Read.
And vain deceit.
Vain deceit.
After the tradition of men.
After the traditions of men. You see that? The white man tell you it's okay. Homosexuality is okay.
Right.
Don't he tell you that? Yeah, then he legalized two men can get married, two women can get married. But they have legalized it though, right? It's not right. You say you don't think that's right, but you think it's
true lies.
No, it's
not. Nothing. I mean, like, don't
put
nothing in none of it. Cocaine, hot pizza, none of it. Breaking none of it.
Right.
None of it. Right.
black folk. All of us don't do it. Some of us still do it. But we got to repent. That's what we're going to talk to you about. But you got to be around like-minded brothers.
Right. I just wanted to say, it's crazy, right?
I understand. I'm sorry. But listen, here's the deceiving part. You carry it, the deceiver is going to allow something to happen to make you use it.
Right.
So he can get you locked up.
Right.
Right. Make you, so you can get locked up and then regret it for the rest of your life. That's what's going to happen. You see that? Read out.
After the rudiment of the world.
After the rudiments of the world, we're still following the world. Read.
And not after Christ.
We got to come back to Christ.
Right.
We got to come back to the laws of God.
Right. I'm saying.
Come on, what?
One of my houses.
Isaiah.
Your
house and stuff. What's that doing? We should say sit there and live in the
bedroom. No, you're missing the point, brother. You're missing the point. Go back to 2 Corinthians.
Do what they say. 6, the 17. You're missing the point. Do whatever they say. When they come after black women,
I feel. Ecclesiastes 8:5. Let me tell you what Christ said. You know Jesus Christ, a black man, right?
Right.
No.
Give me Luke 22. Hey, what? Hey, find a scripture for me. Hey,
right,
somebody look up scriptures for me when Christ said, "Buy a sword." Say something, bro. Because I see you got the gun on your hip.
Listen, bro.
I'm with you, bro. Brother Chris, right? Is it Chris? Chris, Gedaliah, bro. What's your name, B-Dog? Lewis, what's your name, sis?
Samaria.
Maker. I'm with you, bro.
And you want me to be your main housekeeper, though?
Hey, I'm with you 100%, bro. Guess what? You where I was. I had a Glock 17. I had to have with me at all times because I'm from Meridian. Meridian, just like Jackson. They capping brothers left and right. You can't go nowhere. But let me show you what Christ said. You got that?
Yes, sir.
Luke chapter 22, verse 36. Then say he unto them, but now he that has a curse.
Hold on. 1 second. Just 1 second, sis. We're going to let you speak. No, you ain't getting no mic. You're not getting a mic, sister. But listen to this. You all right, big bro. I want you to hear what this said. Read where I'm going to get again.
Then say he unto them, but now he that has a purse, let him take it. And likewise his whip. And he that has no sword, let him sell his garment and buy one.
The Lord said, get your money and buy your sword in the last days. Because God wants us to protect ourselves.
Right.
But understand this, we can't win in a physical war. The war we in is more spiritual than physical. Right. What I mean by it is this, Zechariah 4:6. Our war more spiritual than it's physical. I'm gonna tell you why. Because even like you said, you're like, okay, I got the strap, I go to work, take care of my family, I stay out the way, I don't bother nobody, but I still gotta watch my back out here.
Right.
Watch this, this is because it's spiritual. Watch this, read.
Zechariah chapter 4, verse 6. Then he answered and spake unto me, saying, this is the word of the Lord unto Zerubbabel, saying.
So Zerubbabel was the king's bodyguard, black man. So you know he had what? In order to guard the king, what you gotta have? You gotta have them hands. Zerubbabel, hey. Listen. Zerubbabel was one of the king's bodyguards.
That's right.
So if anybody, he was like the Secret Service. Guess what? He was a black man. He was a Jew like us.
Right.
You feel me? Black man. Now watch this. Read. But watch what God tells Zerubbabel. Read.
Not by might.
You hear what he told Zerubbabel? He said, bro, I know you got hands. I gave you the hands. He's like, but listen to this, though. It ain't by your might, though. It ain't by your strength. Read.
Nor by power.
Nor by your power, because Zerubbabel had the power to whoop any Negro that wasn't his way, or any other nation, right? Watch this, read.
But by my spirit.
God said, look, you can't win this war physically. You got to win it spiritually.
Right.
But guess what, though? Watch this, Ecclesiastes 8:5. So you were missing my soul. What if a dude break up in my house then? You know what I'm saying? What if this happened? What if that happened? Right? I gotta take care of my family. So we're not telling you not to protect your family. But when it comes to our brothers, we want to try not to do that or harm our brothers. But watch this though. Let me show you what God say. This is why I'm gonna show you that it's spiritual. Watch this. Read.
Ecclesiastes chapter 8 verse 5. Whoso keepeth the commandments shall feel no evil thing.
Hold on, sis. I want you to hear this. Listen again.
Whosoever keepeth the commandments.
So if you keep the commandments that the brothers was telling you today, read.
Shall feel no evil thing.
You hear what God says? You ain't gonna feel no evil. Mean,
right.
Ain't nobody because you're keeping the commandments.
Right.
Ain't nobody gonna bother you or harm you or your family. Why? Because you're keeping the commandments.
Right.
I'm gonna show you this. Watch this. Give me the book of 2 Kings chapter 6 verse 14 for the brother real quick. If you keep your commandments of God, you ain't got to worry about nobody harming you. Commandments, you got to look over your shoulder.
Right.
Watch this, read. 2 Kings
Second Kings, chapter 6, verse 14.
Read.
Therefore, sent he hither horses and chariots and a great host, and they came by night and compassed the city about.
So this is what you was talking about, somebody breaking in your house. So they was looking for Elisha. Elisha was a prophet, a black man. You hear me, big bro? He was a prophet, he's a black man. The Assyrian army came and circled the whole city he was in. All these men come to get one man. He was a black man now. Watch this, read. Watch what happened, read.
And when the servants of the man of God.
So when his servants, his homeboys, they saw all these people, watch what they said, read.
Was risen early and gone forth. Behold, and host compassed the city both.
So when he woke up the next morning, he go outside to see what's going on. He see all these men, all these horses, all this army coming to get this one man to listen. He was, they like, bro, they finna come kill us all. Watch this though, read.
Both with horses and chariots.
Read.
And his servant said unto him, Elias, my master, how shall we do? And he answered, fear not.
You hear what he said? It said, the dude was like, what are we supposed to do? You know, like you told me, what am I supposed to do? Negro running up in my house trying to take me and my wife and my kids out. What am I supposed to do, right? Same thing this brother said to Elisha. He didn't understand. Watch what he say. Watch this. Watch, remember I said, keep the commandments of God and you won't feel no evil thing.
Right.
Watch this. Read.
He answered, fear not, for they that be with us are more than they that be with them.
You read that again. What did he say to him?
Bring it out.
For they that be with us.
But fear not.
Fear not, for they that be with us are more than they that be with them.
He said, look, don't worry about that army. They that be with us is more than they that be with them.
Right.
He telling this brother this, and this brother like, you crazy. You don't see this 5,000 men coming to get us? What you mean it's more with us than it is with them? I don't see nobody here but me and you. That's what the brother saying. Watch this. He read.
And Elisha prayed and said, Lord, I pray thee.
Listen to this real close. Elisha then prayed to the Lord and said, Lord, I pray thee. Read.
Open his eyes.
He said what?
Open his eyes.
Because the brother was blind to what was really happening around him. Right. He didn't know. All he seen was the army. Read. Right.
That he may see. And the Lord opened his eyes.
So now the Lord opened the servant's eyes so he can see what Elisha actually saw. Watch this. Read.
And the Lord opened the eyes of the young man.
Read.
And he saw. And behold, the mountain was filled with horses and chariots of fire round about Elisha.
You hear that?
Bring it up.
Elisha had protection
that
couldn't nobody see.
Right.
Why you think we come to the hood and teach our people the Bible?
Right.
Because we got protection that brothers can't see.
Right.
Like you came up here with the strap. You are, but listen. It's okay. You our brother though.
Right.
But something could have been said here to ignite your spirit to make you want to grab it.
Right.
Why weren't we afraid of that?
Why would I do that?
Because you, I understand. But some brothers come up to us, and if they could, I understand. But some, I'm just telling you what some people do.
Right.
Some people come up to us, and they want to hurt us because we teach the Bible. You feel me? But you wouldn't do that. But guess what? The Lord put it on your spirit to not do it. Because God could. Because here's what I'm going to tell you what. Me and you, when God ready to put a spirit on us to do something evil, we can't stop it. When brothers go do a drive-by shooting, the Lord put that spirit on them to do that.
Like, literally, if I beat a nigga ass right now, whatever.
Right. It will be the Lord that put that on you. So what we're telling you now is, there's more protection amongst you. You ain't got to carry no strap.
Right.
I ain't saying you should have it, because you should protect yourself, but I'm saying you don't have to feel like, oh, well, what I'm supposed to do, if somebody do this to me, it don't matter death to me. If you keeping the commandments, you got protection.
Right.
That's what we read right here. If you keep God's commandments, you got protection. That's what he's saying. What did he see in the mountain? Saw what on the mountain? Read.
And behold, the mountain was full of horses and chariots of fire round about Elisha.
Read.
And when they came down to him, Elisha prayed unto the Lord.
Watch this.
And said, smite this people, I pray thee, with blindness.
You see what he said? Elisha prayed to the Lord, and the Lord smit all those men that were trying to look for him, smit him with blindness when he couldn't see him no more. This is what we're reading. We got to believe this. If we believe in the Bible, we got to believe that the Lord going to protect us if we keep the commandments.
Right.
You understand? But when we're not keeping the commandments, we don't have no protection. We remove our hedge of protection.
Right.
That's why we got to keep the commandments so we can be guarded in these last days, bro.
Right.
You feel me?
We used to scream black power while Haram was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold. From Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.